I'm shooting on my Pentax. So what? Let me be honest. I'm absolutely hanging out my ass. I don't even think this is going to be a video. I'm really not feeling it today. Why do I do this? Well, Lady Grey.
So, hey. As that introduction was so pathetic and so miserable, I'm here again to record another intro to talk to you about Lomography Lady Grey. I guess this could be considered one of Lomography's more normal film roles in comparison to the Lomochrome range like Purple or Turquoise. But it's definitely not a film role to be overlooked. Lady Grey comes in a 100 ISO role and a 400 ISO role. I'm shooting the 400 ISO role because it is December and it's the UK, which if you don't know, it's miserable. It is a 35mm black and white negative role. However, it's also available in 120 as well. It's a panchromatic emulsion with a fine grain and a super high dynamic range and a very sophisticated tonal spectrums. Sorry, there's a typo there. I think it's quite an interesting name for a role. I'm not sure why they've called it Lady Grey, and it's in comparison to another, I guess the brother role of it, which is Earl Grey. But it's all quite royal, if you ask me, and quite frankly, I don't give a f***. The results, however, say differently. So we start this journey off in rainy Manchester, and being the social queen that I am, I took some time out of my busy schedule to go and walk around the Northern Quarter and take some photographs. That is a little important message for you all out there. This came out garbage, I know, but it had the potential, it had the dynamic smoke coming out. There's two people in the distance that I could kind of see, but unfortunately my skill and knowledge of how to focus a shot went on vacation, so you just have this blur. I definitely made up for that last shot with this one because this is portfolio potential. If I had a portfolio, I should probably get a portfolio.
Sucks, it's raining, and today I'm calling it off.
So I had a busy evening of socializing ahead of myself. I just shot a few snaps. However, well, these two, solely lit by candlelight, oh my. Even I impressed myself with these photographs. So I left Manchester with an unfinished role, but a couple of days later, I headed on up to Glasgow in Scotland. And yes, you guessed it, in December, I was met by rain, a lot of it. I stayed in a box, a very cheap box. And for some reason, I decided to think that I was really good at photography and take a good photograph in here. I was wrong. I was incredibly wrong. However, I did look good when I was doing it, so believe it or not, I was in Glasgow to socialise. I know, I'm getting very popular, but yeah, I'd gone out for some civilised drinks and a nice meal, and this ended up happening. But more on this thing in another video. So the next morning, I headed out to finish the rest of the role of Lady Grey on the streets of Glasgow. And let's put it this way, I was very delicate this morning.
Why do people drink?
And then I pretty much finished the role and gave up on it and kind of just shot a couple more snaps, waited for my train to go back home. So to conclude is one, I'm not as young as I used to be. And two is don't sleep on Lady Grey, unless she wants it. With the price range at around £8, £9, £10, I think this isn't a bad deal at all. It is so flexible and you get such dynamic toes. It's got incredible dynamic tones. Those tonages, tonage bruh. Tones. So yeah, I think if you have the opportunity to shoot Lady Grey, go and shoot it. But I'm not running to tell people to go and shoot it, but if someone says, oh, this is what I'm using, I will definitely tell them the positive experience I've had with it. So yeah, I'd be willing to see what Lomography's Earl Grey is like as well. And on that shout, I'm gonna go make a brew and get some Earl Grey down my throat.